Hey everybody, it's Las Vegas Lori Ballen, and I am going to show you today how to set up a Google AdWords campaign from your KW Command Center using the Lead Accelerator. So many titles there, right? This is really cool. I am a huge, let me rephrase that. I do Google AdWords. And I am a fan of running pay-per-click ads in conjunction with my earned-in rankings, search engine rankings. There's a very big difference between running a social ad and running a search ad. And one of the reasons I love a good search ad is that somebody is actually looking for that item in some capacity. Where your social advertising, you're bidding on an audience. On search advertising, you're bidding on a keyword still. So I personally enjoy running pay-per-click campaigns, and I also love a lot of the strategy behind it. So I'm excited that KW has rolled out the Lead Accelerator and is giving us the ability to add Google AdWords. So let's go ahead and set up a campaign. So I'm going to click Create New. So you're going to need to go in and set up a Google AdWords account. Feel free to message me if you don't know how to do that. You're going to want to set up a Google AdWords account, and then you're going to want to set up your payment profile on your Lead Accelerator. Once you've done that, you're going to be able to see where you can run ads. Today, we're going to do a Google AdWords. All right, we're going to go ahead and say, let's run this for 10 days. You could change this to a month. You can change this to whatever you want to do. I'm just going to leave it by default right now because I know a lot of you guys are really going to understand like $10 a day, right, to run listing campaigns on your Facebook or on your Twitter or on your Google AdWords. So let's just go ahead and stick with that for now. We're going to say $100, which is $10 per day. We're going to run a listing ad, and the marketing campaign goal is to promote a listing. And we're going to click Configure Campaign. Now, I will be showing you all of the different strategies here to running these campaigns, and I just realized I forgot to give it a name. So I'm going to be running this around a listing. So let me just give this a name here. I'm going to call this 5204 Corey Place Google AdWords. We're going to click Configure Campaign. Now, what I love about this is how easy it is to pull the data directly from our KWLS listing system. Wow, say that three times fast. What you're going to want to do is make sure that your listing is set up correctly first in the KWLS system, that your pictures look good, your descriptions, but you'll be able to edit some stuff here. So let me show you. So select from KWLS. I'm going to type in the address. Now, in my case, it says no records are found. The reason for that is because I have a team, and my team puts their listings in their own name. So I'm going to go up here to only my listings. I'm going to change this to all listings. So my contract with my team says I can market and promote any listing that anybody on the team takes on behalf of the team. I can't just go in here and pick somebody else's listing and market it randomly, right? Got to have permission to do that. So I'm going to click select. All right. So now it's pulling in here. And now we're going to enter the headline. Now, what I like to do here is I like to use keywords, and I like to use features about the house, okay? Now, typically what I find is if I just try to run the address, which I like to have a Google AdWord for the address, so that if somebody's standing in front of the house and they Google the address, they'll find me, it doesn't always come up because there's such a low volume of bidding on that address that they generally won't even approve that ad in that format. So we got to be a little bit clever here. So headline. So let me look at the property and go, okay, what is it about this property that people are going to search on Google that this might be appealing? Okay. So I can tell you based on my experience tracking all of my search data, that people search for things like Las Vegas homes with no HOA. See how this says no HOA? So that might be something I run. I could put two-story, three-bedroom home in Las Vegas. I could put three-bedroom home in-laws in 89107. There's so many ways that I could craft this ad to match a potential keyword search, okay? So if I have the data, which in my case I do, I might go look at my top search terms for both my pay-per-click campaigns and my search campaigns and determine what is going to get the most amount of searches, okay? And I might run it that way. I might also run this ad three different ways. I might run 100, 100, 100 and just change up the keywords, okay? So let's go ahead and do, this one doesn't have a pool, right? A pool is one I always use, no pool. And it's also not gated. So those aren't going to be anything that I use. So I'm definitely going to run three bedroom home in 89107 with no HOA. Does it fit? It does fit. Okay, perfect. Now another tip, capitalize every word in your headline, your subheading, and in your description. These are best practices in Google AdWords. And why does it matter? Google AdWords has what's called a quality score. This is similar to the relevance score on Facebook, where the more click-throughs you get, the better the landing page performs, the better your landing page matches your ad as far as what the user thought they were getting when they clicked on the URL, you're gonna get a higher quality score. The higher quality score you get, the less you pay per click and the higher up you are in the rankings. So this is really an important part of your strategy if you're running Google AdWords, okay? And we're using commands, so there isn't something guiding us on best practices. So I'm giving them to you as I know them, okay? So now your headline too. Now this could be where we take advantage of the address, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and see how much of that's going to fit there. Perfect. That actually fits. See these little numbers? This is how many characters you're allowed to use and how many you did use. So here I've got 30 out of 30 and here I've got 30 out of 30. That's also a best practice. You want to use the space provided. Okay. So now we're going to enter the display path. Okay. So this is going to be, it's a little bit tricky on here. Let me see, let me go down and put the URL and see if it adds that by default. Now, again, I'm always talking about my wish list on here if I need to get in the labs, but I would have that show up, I would have the URL first, and then I would have that URL populate the next two fields by default because it's going to be confusing for us. However, let me just go ahead and say this. Final URL is going to be wherever you want to send them for that listing, okay? Now, I like to use the Google URL Builder, which is now bit.ly, bit.ly, and the Google URL Builder are now linked, but I'm going to put in my website URL here, and I'm doing this for tracking purposes because what I don't know yet is how command is going to list the sources. So it might automatically show me this was a pay-per-click ad off Google off of this keyword, yet I don't know that yet. So I'm going to go ahead and just as a best practice put in my tracking URL. Campaign source is going to be Google PPC, the campaign medium, Google cost per click. Campaign name is Corey Place. And I'm going to go ahead and stop right there. Copy URL. And we'll go paste this into here. See that? Okay. Now, display path is going to look something like this. It's going to have BallenVegas.com, which is the top level domain, slash. Now you're going to put in your keywords, something like three bedroom homes. And what that should do is it's going to get rid of this long, ugly URL, which actually in my case, I'm not going to load the bit.ly because I was having a problem with Google AdWords not loading my bit.ly URL. So let's just try this for a second. I want to make sure, see how it works. So we're just going to go ahead and put in the long URL here. And then here, this should change your display path to now say ballenvegas.com/3bedroom/home up here instead. That URL is for aesthetics. It's for visuals. When they click it, they're still going to go to this long URL. So the best practice is you put your top level domain and you put in your keywords, whatever it is that you're going for here. And I could change that to 89107. Oh, nope, it's not going to let me. So I could do 3 bedroom 89107. See how that works? So we're going to include some of those keywords. Okay. Now, this is interesting. Okay. So add up to 10 keywords. All right. So if we're using Google AdWords directly, we're using a software like I do to manage all my Google AdWords account, we've got unlimited abilities to add keywords. However, when we're marketing a listing, that's not going to probably be necessary to do all of that. So we're going to do something here like 3 bedroom. Is this going to let me put the location? No. So it's going to be important that we are using our location here. It doesn't look like we have the ability to set a geographic location on this ad at this point. Therefore, we want to make sure, unless they're defaulting it, but it doesn't look like it. So we want to make sure our keyword, our location that is in there. So I'm going to do 3 bedroom, Las Vegas. And I'm going to do 3 bedroom, 89107. And I'm going to do Las Vegas home, no HOA. And I'll do Las Vegas home under 300K. So I'm going to type in things that I think people are typing into Google that this home might actually fit. Home for sale in 89107. Home for sale in Las Vegas, 290,000. Home in Las Vegas, 300. Thousand. Nope. That dollar sign. We want to make sure we're not using that dollar sign. My bad on that one. Okay. And we'll take out the comma. There we go. Okay. Maybe I want to put Keller Williams, Las Vegas, in case somebody's searching for that specifically. How many do we have now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Can't wait to see how this rolls out, like in the control panel, because it's not giving me the ability to make each one of those either a broad match or a phrase match or an exact match. So I don't know how those are going to list yet at this point. Again, we're in the very basics of all of this as it's just rolling out. So I'm going to assume there's more advanced features coming for people like me, but we will continue to follow and I will let you know. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I could also do 3 bed house Vegas, and I could do 89107, no HOA. Let's just start here. I'll come back after this video, and once this is live, I'll report what I'm seeing, where this is showing up, what it looks like we can do at that point, because it's all completely unknown at this point. I ran a Facebook ad from command a couple days ago, made a video, and it has not yet been approved. So I'm still waiting to see how that's going to show up, and I will let you guys know. Oh, there's our geographic locations. Hold on. Interesting. I don't know what that's going to do. It's not like pulling up a map. It's not giving me the geo-targeting option, so I don't even know if that's going to work. But let's just go ahead and put Las Vegas, Nevada, and we'll see what happens. Okay. Oh, I see. It should be loading a map, and it's not loading a map. Looks like it should be loading that. Okay, so that's probably coming. This is, again, I'm just doing that kind of a beta. This is fine that they're going to be working on it. So, all right. So our geographic location isn't working at this moment. So let's just go ahead and my keywords will protect me on that for now. and I'll come back once that's active and show you how to change that so that you can use the geotargeting instead. All right, now ad placement. Do we want this to show up in the search network? Do we want it to show up in the display network, or do we want it to show up on both? So your search network's going to show your ad only on Google. Your display network's going to display your ad on Google Partner. So for example, Google might have a relationship with Pandora, the music app. And I'm using this as a real life example because it actually happened to me. I got a message from my adult daughter's best friend who said she saw my ad on Pandora. Well, I wasn't running the ad on Pandora. It was a display network ad. And because I've given permission to show it with Google's display network, it shows up on those places as well. Okay, so you can test this and say, do I want it to be searched? Do I want it to be displayed? Do I want it to be both? And then I'm going to leave it on both so that I can see how the reporting comes out. Then I'm going to click Save and Activate. Ah, we may not be able to activate without that map. Oh, darn. Yeah, so what's happening is because our list is not loading, we're not going to be actually able to place this ad yet. So what I'm going to go ahead and do for now is click Save as a Draft. Let's see if it'll let me save it, and I'm going to click Yes. Okay, so what we will do is as soon as we have the ability to grab that little map, and maybe you have it on your end. If you do, then you're fine. Just go ahead and put in that geolocation, click Save, and run your ad. If you don't, then save it as a draft, and we will come back and place it as soon as that is loading live. So that's the first look at how we will be able to run an ad in Google AdWords. And like I said, I will continue to come back and report how these things show up once they're actually live and running, how we read our reports, how we can improve click-through rate, all of that good stuff. And I'll be on the journey with you. Thanks for watching.